everybody, and welcome back to another Wheel of Time video. Today's video is going to be more of a reaction podcasty type of video, so don't expect a whole lot of stuff on screen. You can listen to this one more than anything. I will be throwing up on the screen, though, some of the reactions to Rafe's Q&A today. That's really, by the way, that's the purpose of the video. What I want to do is run through the five questions that Rafe did for Watt Wednesday. And the question was answering the five questions about Rosamund Pike's casting as Moraine. So what we're going to do in this video, I'm going to read through the Q&A. We'll go over it together. And then I want to give you my reaction to that kind of stuff, just kind of off the cuff. So I won't be doing a whole lot of editing. Hopefully you don't mind that. You get to hear me breathe and stuff. So any case, guys, let me go ahead and throw up a spoiler warning for the video. This video will carry a spoiler rating of green, meaning there will be no spoilers of any kind other than kind of the press release stuff about Moraine. So feel free to watch, even if you have kind of just a passing interest in the show. If you haven't read the books at all, feel free to watch. So let's go ahead and dive in. What I am going to be doing, just to kind of condense this, the Daily Trolloc. If you guys don't look at the Daily Talk, there's lots of good news there. But Narg basically compiled the Q&A, and so what you're going to see on your screen is an area where he did that. So shout out to the Daily Trolloc. That's just going to save us from having to find all the different responses to the tweets. So any case, let's go ahead and dive on in here. So again, the prompt for the Q&A, if you guys didn't know already, Rosamund Pike has been cast as Moraine in the Wheel of Time TV show. I did a speculation video, not necessarily a speculation video, but a video as we had heard the rumors and then it was later confirmed. And so I haven't really said that on a video yet. So if you did not already know that, Rosamund Pike has been cast as Moraine. That is confirmed. She's a pretty awesome actress with a lot of background. So go back and watch that video where I go through a lot of her background. What the prompt, I guess, Rafe gave for the Watt Wednesday today, or that came out today, was you could ask five questions about Rosamund Pike and Moraine in the casting. And so what they did is they picked five of them based on all the questions people threw at him, and then he answered them today. So we're going to go through those. So let's go ahead and kick it off here with question one. What was the clincher in your talks with Rosamund that made you go, yes, this is Moraine? So Rafe said, there were two. The first was the moment I heard her voice on the other side of the phone, and it truly felt like Moraine's voice, almost instantaneously. The second was after she spoke about Moraine's mission and what it meant to her as a character, how it affected Moraine's life, and how she sees those she cares about. It was 100% clear she deeply understood Moraine and the forces that drive her. Okay, so let's stop with that answer. First of all, I will give you my upfront reaction to all these questions, and you'll kind of see this come through in my reactions to these. I feel very much more confident about the casting hearing Rafe talk about this. So right off the bat, when he says that he heard her voice and he knew that almost instantaneously she was Moraine. So a lot of this is headcanon stuff, but Moraine does have a forcefulness to her. It's almost as though she's right and she talks in assumptions. She has a firmness or a confidence in her voice. So I'm wondering if that is what came through to Rafe as he heard her on the phone. So that's kind of interesting, but so that's a little bit more speculation. But then the second part of this answer, though, is where I really, it was key. Because he said, you know, she understood Moraine's mission and what it meant to her as a character. And so if you know that much, if you've watched Moraine, she's very mission-driven. So I guess, you know, I don't want to get too much into it to go into spoilers, but she's mission-driven. Let's just put it that way. And so because she cares so much for what her mission is, that's what drives all of her actions. Okay. And so it was really interesting to see him say that, because for Rosamund to understand that is going to be really, really important in adapting the character. So I'm really, really excited for that. Let's hit on question two here. How many people did you look at potentially playing Moraine, and what made Rosamund stand out above all the others? So Rafe said to that, we swung for the fences with Moraine. We said for this character, any actress on earth is fair game. And we were inundated with women excited about playing her, from household names to Oscar winners. After the phone call with Rosamund, though, I simply knew it must be her. Okay, so because there's a lot to look into in that statement. So the question was basically, who did you look at? I mean, were there other people that you looked at? And he said, basically, we swung for the fences. Anybody was fair game. We knew we were going to cast somebody big for this role, is basically what he's saying. He's also saying there were a lot of people interested in it, which that says something about the series right there, that it's got enough of a buzz among the people behind the scenes, so the agents, things like that, that are pitching this role. To me, what it says is that Amazon is putting a lot of money and a lot of its weight behind this because they want to create something big. So the fact that they were getting interest from household names and Oscar winners says a lot. This isn't going to be a cheap... So for a lot of you who have been replying in comments saying, I don't want another, Shannara series on MTV, like you're thinking that's what it's going to be, or another Sword of Truth adaptation. I don't think that's what we're getting at all. You don't get Oscar winners and people like that that are interested in the role and putting the money into it that Amazon is, if that's what it is. So right off the bat, that says something to me that they did have interest there. It also then lends a lot more to when they chose Rosamund, they knew it must be her. That gets me pretty excited, because say what you want about the showrunners. I know a lot of you have very varying opinions on that. They do love the books. There's an intricate knowledge. They've brought on advisors that know the books. Harriet's involved. For them to say, nope, we knew this was Moraine, that has me very encouraged. So let's hit on question three here. How much emphasis will the writers and showrunners place on actors' physical traits with the characters? For example, Rosamund is significantly taller than Moraine. Will the show use angles and gimmicks to show Moraine being short? Or will we just see Rosamund being Rosamund? And Rafe's response to that was, I'm of the belief that my most important job is to bring the truth and heart of these characters to life. I'm much more concerned about acting than physicality. I remember being a kid and seeing Hugh Jackman would play Wolverine and was furious. He's 6'3 and Wolverine is 5'3. To me, it was against the very core of the character that he would be tall. But the truth is, when I saw X-Men, of course Hugh Jackman was Wolverine. It's so much more important to me to get someone who is high caliber, who embodies the character, than a perfect physical match. Plus, there's a lot we can do with wigs and dye and lighting to achieve the iconic looks of the Wheel of Time characters. I think Twitter of Time will be very happy when they see it. Okay, believe it or not, there's actually a ton to unpack in here that tells us a lot about what they're going to be doing casting and their philosophy behind it. So let's first start off by this. I agree with Rafe here. I would rather them bring in really high caliber actors and actresses than focusing on, hey, he's supposed to be this tall comparatively. There's only a few characters that matters for, and the reality is it really doesn't matter that much at all. It's a plot point to differentiate, for instance, the Aiel than other characters, but there are other ways they can do that. So if all of the Aiel aren't 6'4", I'm not going to be like, screw this, I hate this series. Like, yes, that's important. I want that to be the case. I don't think they're not going to do that, so let me be clear. I'm using that as an example, but it would not break the series for me if they had short Aiel. It just wouldn't. So any case, so what they're saying is we're going to focus on getting high caliber people than just necessarily trying to say they look exactly like the description that we got in the book. I am all for that. I would much rather have a high caliber actress or actor than having a person that looks exactly like the character that's a terrible actor. So that right off the bat that's a positive for me. Now, I love that he invokes the Wolverine and Hugh Jackman reference, because that's totally true. If you know anything about the comic books, Wolverine is known for being short. And then they cast somebody who's really tall. So I don't think anybody would argue that Hugh Jackman was a bad Wolverine. So there you go. Now, there's a lot more to look into this, though, because I want you to hear this last part. We said, plus there's a lot we can do with wigs and dye and lighting to achieve the quote-unquote iconic looks of the Wheel of Time characters. Now, I think those quotations can mean a couple things. Maybe, you know, put my tinfoil hat on here and say that I think it could mean more than what he's saying. The iconic looks part of this, like, yes, there's a look that a lot of the characters have, but I think he's also mentioning what, like, the Aes Sedai, you know, minor spoiler, I don't think it's much of one, but very minor, you might want to earmuffs if not, but when he talks about the Aes Sedai ageless look, that's an iconic look. And I think what he's saying is we're not really concerned about casting somebody who can pull that off, but there are things that we can do with wigs and dye and lighting, which I love. First of all, I love that he didn't mention CGI, because I don't want to see that done in CGI. What I am really cool for is practical effects, and they can do that with wigs and dye and lighting. So there you have it. Question four. What accent will she, and by extension other Kyrianans, perhaps, be using? Rafe, good catch. This is something we talk a lot about. I'd like to build the accents around the lead characters from that place, Rosamund's perfect RP for Kyrian, Arlan's accent from the Malkyrie, etc. To me, it's always about getting the best performers in key roles. So here Rafe is reiterating the same things. He's basically saying, we want to get the best person for this. We're going to try to keep them in their normal accent. So, and then we'll base the rest of those countries around that accent. I'm all for that. So there's a couple things that we can read into that. Number one, what he is saying is accents and by extension culture are going to be something that they are trying to differentiate. So for those of you who are worried that, you know, people from Andor are going to be the same as the Kyrianans, we get basically got an answer that said, no, they're not going to do that. So that's encouraging to me. So right off the bat, I love that. I love that they're not going to try to force people into necessarily accents they can't do. I always find that kind of cheesy when it's a terrible accent. So that's cool with me. What it also tells me, though, is in their land casting, they want somebody who maybe looks or talks differently than Rosamund. Well, Rosamund's English. So maybe they're not going to be hiring another English actor for Lan, which maybe goes into my casting choices for Lan, by the way, which I did choose an Asian actor. Go watch that video if you want to see who I picked, who they might cast for Lan. I still think he's a possibility. So in any case, take a look at that. So question five, and wrapping it up here. Of all of her amazing qualities, what was the biggest one that makes her Moraine to you? And again, referring to Rosamund. Rafe, in truth, it's her acting. It's not a cop-out. That's not a cop-out answer. So much is asked of this character throughout the series, and I needed someone who was truly one of the world's best to pull it off. And luckily for us, we got her. Okay, so this is a little bit more just, blowing smoke. I don't want to say blowing smoke, but basically propping up their choice of Rosamund. This is what he should say. I also think it is true. She is a great actress. So I wouldn't expect him to say, hey, we settled for her, because they clearly didn't. She's awesome. And so her acting, again, if you have not seen her, watch Gone Girl. You can't help but be impressed in that among her other works. So we're in good hands with this. She seems to be taking the character very seriously. So I am very, very excited for it. So guys, real quick in wrapping up, my reaction to this questionnaire, while we got not a ton of information, we did get some, I'm encouraged by it. I'm encouraged by the fact that I feel like they are approaching the casting in the right way, in my opinion. I want them to cast quality people over just looking the part. That was a worry of mine, and it seems to be alleviated. So I'm very happy with that. What do you all think? Does this leave you more encouraged, less encouraged? Tell me what you think in the comments below. Also, please hit the like button if you like the content and you want to see more of what I got. And of course, subscribe to the channel if you want to be updated when I release new content. Check out the Patreon if you would like to support what I'm doing here as we're kind of building up to the show. One of the big goals of mine is to hire a part-time editor to help me get out more videos. For those of you who know who are in my Discord server, you know I'm fairly busy. I run a business outside of this, and so sometimes that's difficult to get stuff out. So any of you who are wanting to support what I do and want to see more content, you can support the channel over on the Patreon. Also, check out the Audible affiliate link below if you want to get a free audiobook. All you have to do is sign up for a trial, and you get a free one. And that also really helps support the channel. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching. Again, give me your comments below, and until next time, peace out.
Tinker in the kitchen with a job of work to do. Mistress up above, slipping on a rope of blue. She prances down the staircase, a fancy oh so free. Crying, Tinker, oh dear Tinker, won't you mend a pot for me?